So today we are going to study about branches of anthropology. Right? So in UPSC syllabus, we have four branches mentioned in our syllabus, and that is first biological anthropology, second sociocultural anthropology, and third linguistic anthropology. And then archaeological anthropology. Right? But applied anthropology is not mentioned in syllabus, but we will also study applied anthropology. Right? So first, when we are going to study biological anthropology, so we can define it. Biological anthropology. Biological anthropology is the branch of anthropology, which deals with the study of human biological evolution and biological variation in biocultural perspective. Right? So two things here important for us when we are going to study biological anthropology. So first important thing, we have to study about human biological evolution. Right? First aspect is human biological evolution. And second aspect is human biological variation. These are two important aspects. First, we have to study human biological evolution. When did human evolve? What was the process of human evolution? But in our syllabus, when we are going to study, so for the understanding of evolution, we also study about theory of organic evolution, which mentioned in topic number 1.4, right? And some important concept related to understanding of organic evolution, like parallelism and convergence and adaptive radiation and mosaic evolution, right? So first important thing that we will study in 1.4. Second, in 1.5 we will study about primate. So we will not only study human evolution, but we will also study about primate evolution. right? For better understanding. But generally many newcomer students are not familiar with primate, right? So basically primate is an order of mammal in which prosimian, monkey, ape and human are included. So most of students are familiar with monkey, ape and human, but they are not familiar with prosimian. So basically when we are going to study this aspect, evolution, so we study human evolution, that is the subject matter of paleoanthropology. And we study primate, that is the subject matter of primatology, right? But when we study about primate, so we study about evolution of primate, and evolution of primate behavior. Both. We will also study about evolution of primate behavior, right? And basically human behavior, human social behavior is regulated through our socio-cultural norms, our socio-cultural rules, our law. But anthropologists mainly focus to study about evolution of social behavior of prosimian, monkey and ape. So when we try to understand about human evolution, basically we have to study about biological evolution of human being, as well as we can understand about how human behavior evolved, why we are behaving in particular way, right? So for the understanding of evolution of human behavior, we have studied about evolution of non-human primate behavior. This is very important for us. And another important branch of biological anthropology, that is paleopathology. This is new branch of biological anthropology by the help of bioarchaeology. Means we utilize biological data and also we utilize about archaeological data. So these important branches are mainly concerned with the study of human evolution, primate evolution, evolution of human behavior, evolution of primate behavior, and evolution of disease in human ancestor. This is very important for us, right? So that we will study. Second important thing, in human biological variation, this is also very important for us, because when we thinking about we belongs from Homo sapiens sapiens species, so all human are belongs from Homo sapiens sapiens species. So how they look like differ in their physical trait, this is also very important topic for us, because if you try to observe about contemporary human physical traits, you can found about there is variation in their physical trait. So variation in the physical trait of contemporary human society. That is, due to genetical factor and environmental factor. Right? So genetics provide us genetical factor, how genetical factors are responsible for occurrence of variation in human society or occurrence in variation of physical traits of contemporary human being. And environmental factor or ecological factor analyze that variation in the term of adaptation. Right? Basically, different human group have been adopted different ecology, different environment, and in different way. And therefore, different types of physical trait evolve in different human group. So variation occur due to genetical factor and variation occur due to adaptational factor, ecological factor and environmental factor. We will study in this biological anthropology basically when we study about human biological variation. But human biological variation is studied by human genetics. First, second is population genetics, third is raciology, next ecological anthropology, epidemiological anthropology, human growth and development, human reproductive biology, human anatomy, human physiology, human osteology, etc. That we will study. But another important thing also we study about applied biological anthropology. When we try to study this topic, these important sub-branches of anthropology, so we also give attention about how knowledge, data, theory, method developed by biological anthropologists are useful for the solution of biocultural problems of mankind in contemporary society. Right? So we will also study about applied biological anthropology like forensic anthropology, like nutritional anthropology, like anthropology of sports, designing defense, genetic counseling gin therapy etc right we will study when you are going to study biological anthropology so you have to give attention about that and in our syllabus basically in topic number 1.4 to 1.6 we will study about topic related to human biological evolution or primate evolution and topic number 9.1 to 11 we will study about human biological variation and topic number 12 we will study about topic related to applied biological anthropology but when we are going to study biological anthropology we also study try to understand about development of biological anthropology means it is known as a physical anthropology in 19th century and presently most of people say it is a physical anthropology right but there is a concept related to new physical anthropology new physical anthropology concept related to new physical anthropology there is development of concept of new physical anthropology that concept was developed by Sherwood L. Washburn in 1951 in his famous work new physical anthropology so we have to know what is new physical anthropology and then we have to know presently it is known as a biological anthropology it is a biological anthropology so basically when you try to understand about physical anthropology here we only discuss that concept physical anthropology so in 19th century when there was development of anthropology as a independent discipline as a independent subjects so in 19th century basically we study human evolution and human biological variation right these are two important aspect of biological anthropology still today but in 19th century there was little development in the field of genetics Mendel has proposed his law of inheritance in 1865 but that was not accepted by intellectuals of that time right so there was little development in the field of genetics so when anthropologists study human evolution they study human evolution on the basis of fossils record still we study human evolution on the basis of fossils record but in that time they interpret that fossils record on the basis of anthropometric measurement which is focused to a study about disease of previous or earlier human being by the help of bioarchaeology. Means in that branch of biological anthropology, we study about origin evolution of origin evolution and development of disease in human ancestor, right? And in that time, in that section, they are using craniometry, osteometry, right? So you are again and again hearing about the cranial capacity of Australopithecus, Neanderthal or Homo erectus or Homo sapiens, and they are measuring the bone of that fossil's remains, and on the basis of they are using comparative anatomy for the understanding of evolution. On the basis of that, they interpret how human evolved, right? They are also making some correlations between environment and ecology of that time, but we have not the advanced technology, advanced method for interpreting these types of data. How did human evolve? And basically in that time they give attention about the physique of fossils remains. They interpret their data on physical aspect of that fossils remains, that is therefore that is known as a physical anthropology. Second important thing is that for the study of human biological variation, they mainly study about racial differences of contemporary human population. So basically racial differences, they try to observe about the racial differences on the basis of observation, observing about the skin color or hair texture and nose form, eye form, and they also using anthropometric measurement, cephalometry, and on the basis of that data they are interpreting about variation of human being in 19th century. So still here they are focusing about the study of physical trait of human being, and therefore it is known as a physical anthropology. This term is still popular in our contemporary society, but when you are going to prepare that topic for UPSC exam or any state PCS exam, so you have to familiar with that development, right? Second important thing is that new physical anthropology. So that concept developed by Sherwood, L. Vaswan in his famous work New Physical Anthropology. He wrote an article named New Physical Anthropology, and in that article he introduced that term New Physical Anthropology. So when we are going to study about New Physical Anthropology, at first we have to understand how that New Physical Anthropology is new or newer than Physical Anthropology. Means we will study how new physical anthropology is different from physical anthropology. This is important thing. So basically, in 1950 onward, there was development in various disciplines. There was development in human genetics. There was development in population genetics. There was development in biochemistry, computer science, ecology and environment. There was advanced development in primatology also. So basically, Sherwood L. was once said that when we are going to study about human evolution, or human biological variation, right? So we should follow interdisciplinary approach. Basically, what it means? It means still we are going to study human evolution on the basis of fossils record. Fossils record is main sources for the understanding of human evolution. Right? Earlier, that fossils record interpreted by only anthropometric measurement method. Right? Now he said that because there is development of human genetics, population genetics, ecology, environment, biochemistry, molecular genetics, computer science, statistics. So now we are capable to interpret this fossils record on the basis of anthropometric measurement as well as in the light of human genetics, population genetics, biochemistry, molecular genetics, ecology, using computer science. Right? Earth science, data related to earth science, and then we can understand about human evolution. Means now we are capable to understand human evolution more holistically, and therefore it is known as a new physical anthropology. First important thing we have to understand. This is new physical anthropology because now we can interpret fossils remains by the application of new theories, new data, new method, new technology. Because now we can utilize DNA dating. That was not available in 19th century. So when you are going to study human evolution or a spread of human in Asia, Europe, America, Australia, so we are using meat DNA, mitochondrial DNA. Right? So these types of development when we are capable to use these types of technique development, then we can capable to understand human evolution in more holistic perspective, broad perspective. And therefore, he suggests that we should change the name of physical anthropology, that new physical anthropology is better term for the interpretation of that branch of anthropology. Second, in the study of human evolution, so in 19th century they mainly study about racial differences, and they study racial differences on the basis of anthropometric measurement. Now we are capable to utilize this important method technique for the study of racial differences. One thing here, for the study of racial differences, we can utilize data related to human genetics, method related to human genetics, population genetics, biochemistry, molecular genetics, ecology, and we can also utilize computer science, application of computer science, etc. So now we are capable to understand racial differences in broad perspective. Another important thing, there was development of ecological anthropology. So how people lived in particular ecological niche, and what was the impact of that particular ecological environmental niche on the physical variation of mankind, that become very important aspect of biological anthropology. Another, I already said that for the study of physical variation, we also study about variation, different physical behavior of human being regarding particular disease, particular virus, bacteria, or microorganism, mosquito, right? Because these are important factors which create disease in human being, but they are not influencing all human being in similar way, right? There is differences. So here they noticed about that differences also. Another important thing evolved in that time, that was a study of primate behavior. Because now anthropologists feel that if we try to study about human evolution or primate evolution without understanding of their evolution, their evolution of their behavior, we can't understand evolution, human evolution in totality. So they started a study of primate behavior, basically non-human primate behavior, in their natural environment by participation or by observation, right? They observing about their behavior in their natural environment, right? Jean Goodell has studied about the behavior of chimpanzee from 1960, and therefore UPSC has asked question on that. The study of Jane Goodell on the primate behavior. So this is known as a new physical anthropology. And because after 1918, there is very advanced development in the field of biological anthropology, and we started using biocultural approach for the understanding of human evolution and human biological variation, so it is known as a biological anthropology. So everybody who want to understand biological anthropology, they have to give attention about this approach of a biological anthropology. Without understanding of this important approach, This important concept we can't understand biological anthropology in right perspective. So this is biological anthropology, right?